Okay, so here's a tube amp I made. This was inspired by the video that CoolDudeclem did recently where he made a tube amp. So this is basically the same circuit he used. But instead of having the volume control over here, I moved it over here. So that's the circuit. You can go over to his video and see a much better schematic than this. So it uses a 12 watt pentode and a small triode, and works great. I'll just get it hooked up and do a vid.
For instance, here's an experiment that he and his colleagues did.
Take a snapshot of someone's face at baseline when they're showing no emotion.
Blank face.
And then get them to try to look as happy.
It has plenty of volume.
Impression guy.
And almost like a contour map, you could actually look at the amount of change, the amount of muscle movement.
In millimeters on each side of the thing.
I'm actually overdriving the speaker. This is putting about 5 or 10 watts out, and this is only like a 5 watt speaker, so.
They're doing it slightly more strongly on the left side of the face.
Now, if this is the case, that our left side is sort of saying more emotionally than our right side, then if you think about the mirror, it's kind of a discombobulating thing. You know, because it's taking your left, which is sort of broadcasting emotion, flipping it to your right, you're seeing yourself, you're all mixed up. You don't know.
Okay, so now I'm going to turn it off and show what's on the inside. Okay, so this is the inside of the amp. As you can see, it's pretty simple. You have the main filter caps over here. Here's the cathode bypass cap for the main output tube. And here's the one for the first stage of audio. Right here is a rheostat for this tube, for the small tube, because it uses more current than it should, so I just put a little rheostat there. So that's the main circuit. This is the volume control. And I'll just do some more. Do some more clips of it playing.
This is King FM, listener-supported classical music, available at king.org and in smartphone apps. Bringing you King FM online is made possible through your financial support. Make a difference. Donate now at king.org.
Comes from KUOW members and PCC Natural Markets, offering a selection of game day food in the PCC Deli, including take and bake pizzas and dips and spreads, with 9 neighborhood locations. More at PCCNaturalMarkets.com.
Rejecting everything.
Yeah, I've always had a DNA for that kind of expressionistic cinema and their soundtracks. I mean, Fellini, for example.
Nino Rota, Fellini's composer.
Incredible.
Your soundtracks are also often anachronistic. In Moulin Rouge, you have turn-of-the-century Parisians dancing to Smells Like Teen Spirit.
Gatsby,
you have 20s partygoers dancing to a tune by Fergie and Q-Tip.
Yes.
What attracts you to that?
Honestly, with Moulin Rouge, it came from a desire to reignite the musical. And musicals had, White Christmas, the song, is in several movies. Musicals didn't have completely new scores. So the whole idea of using familiar music plus some new music was born out of just the desire to reinvent a musical. To test the film, people go, what scene did you like the most? Then they'd say Gatsby and Daisy meeting, and the second most popular one was the orgy scenes in the weekend. So I cut the orgy down a bit, I have to tell you.
So we can blame that all on Kanye, basically.
Well, on the Blu-ray, at some point I wanted to just run one of the shots uncut.
Oh man, you're appealing to our audience's prurient interest.
Well, you'll find it fascinating as an acting exercise just how committed they were.
Absolutely.
Certainly my assistant enjoyed being kissed by all those girls.
I wanted to ask you about what I think is the greatest musical moment in your work. It is the climax of the love song medley between Nicole Kidman and Ewan McGregor in Moulin Rouge. They suddenly break into the song, I Will Always Love You.
Yes.
I remember seeing that on opening night, and the audience went crazy. Song for that moment? Did you know it would have that impact?
Mine's participatory cinema. I literally expect the audience to participate. Like the fact that the audience applaud when Leonardo comes on.
Okay, that is pretty much it. I'll put a link to CoolDudeClem's video in the description, and thanks for watching.